job, get a real job, get a real, get a real job, get a job.
Hey, thanks for watching. I play to this sort of stuff normally, underground punk rock and ska. So if like music discovery or this kind of music is your jam, feel free to follow. I'm dedicating my stream these days to kind of showcase lesser known musicians during these hard times. Thanks for watching.
I'm boldly click our mouths. We're the one who's coming for all. We fight our famine and our misery without walking out the door. Which we protect with an update to our friends. We can just get 2,000 more.
Sup, Bicep Drums? Nice to see you, man. How's it going, dude? We'll be right back. I saw that you streamed earlier today. I hope that went well. Sorry I couldn't stop by. I was busy sorting through my photos. I have like a backlog to sort through so I can post BLM related photos. But dude, it's good to see that you're like regularly streaming, man. Next time I come to your stream, I'm gonna request a song from these guys. They have like really interesting, they combine like ska and like gypsy songs, or like gypsy styles, I guess. Eastern European, I think, styles together. Oh yeah. Yeah, it's really weird, right? Like the stuff I play, it tends to be really weird and obscure, but hopefully it grows on you. A lot of it I don't like initially when I hear it, but it grows on me after like repeated listens. Thanks for stopping by, dude. Really happy to see you. That's a good question. They're from the UK. Actually, surprisingly, a lot of ska. Ska is like relatively popular in the UK. And then not so much in America. America, it was like the popularity was the peak with in the 90s with No Doubt and Sublime. Those were like the biggest ska bands here, or like Mighty Mighty Boss Tones. But like ska originated in Jamaica and then like spread to the UK and has like a pretty strong foothold in the UK. So like a lot of prominent ska artists these days you'd actually find from the UK. It's pretty interesting. Oh, you played in a number of ska bands? No way. Oh, really? That's cool, man. I had no idea. Unless you're trolling me. If so, you gotta link me to some stuff, man. I'm trying to like spread the word to some like obscure ska bands. Even if they're like disbanded and no longer exist, I wanna kinda like spread the word about the underground scene. Dude, if it's dude. Most local bands consider themselves to be total trash because they're not very popular, but that couldn't be further from the truth. I feel like there's like a lot of good stuff out there. Sure, there may be like subpar or like not so interesting stuff, but it still deserves to be preserved or like be known about, right? So then maybe if like some other person had like the idea, oh, I'm gonna play this kind of thing, and then they hear someone else has done it, they'd be dissuaded from doing that, right? If it's like actually total trash. That's just like a theory, but I feel like everything, even trash, needs to be known. What was I gonna say? There was something was thinking of calling you. Shoot. Oh, I have. I was in a band, in a ska band, or a pop punk ska band, for a little while. That I think was relatively unpopular and you could consider trash. So, if you tell me your band, I'll tell you my band. How about that? You do a deal. You can whisper it to me. You don't have to post it to the public. But I want to check out your stuff. But dude, like, you've improved so much since I started seeing you. I'm sure I've told you this before. Like, it's surprising. Like, especially when, like, newer drummers or, like, people just starting out, especially then when they have a knack for it, they'll, like, skyrocket. And that's also kind of, like, my trajectory initially. I, like, skyrocketed, like, the first few years, and then I plateaued for a while. And it's been a struggle, like, increasing my skill level from there. Thanks. I do have a trash ska band I was part of, a trash pop punk ska band. It's true. I'll prove it to you. Just whisper me what yours is, and I'll trade you my information. I'm not lying, man. I'm straightforward. I'm a man of my word. All right, man. If you really don't want to share it, no worries. But I think you'd be surprised. I'm actually very, very tolerant of all sorts of music. Especially if you go back to like more like that screamo, like hardcore stuff. That sounds almost like grindcore, which is like utter garbage. Oh my god. I still tolerate that. Like, I've back in high school when I was into ska, or like got into ska, I was like, oh, I'd never like opt for a screamo and like that stuff. And then it's kind of like slowly I've been able to tolerate it. When like my other friends, like my brothers, then like, oh, what the heck is that noise? Turn off that garbage. Oh, nice. Yeah, dude. Hopefully it's on your channel page so I can check it out. I had no idea, dude. I wish you shared that with me. Because I'm all about that off-tempo stuff. My teeth, my hair, my happiness aside. I hope you do finish it, and let me know if you like any assistance or anything whatsoever, if I can offer any help whatsoever, because it'd be awesome. I'm all about people finishing their works of art and preserving for posterity. So like, yeah, if I can help in any way, let me know, and I wish you the best of luck on that. I look forward to hearing it. Dude, if you do your own music or whatever, like a local act, like ska punk related especially, let me know and I'll put it on my list of artists to cover and stream to. Thanks, Tito. Nice to see you. Nice to see fellow drum streamers in my stream. Thanks for the support, guys. You were killing it earlier on your stream, man. I was so happy to see over 100 people watching. Oh, man. So awesome.
Guttural
Hopefully you got a lot of follows from that, man. Hopefully it converted pretty well for you. If I remember correctly, I think someone that was in on one of the raids that went to Tita Nitro told me that Kit Boga initially raided the stream he was at. I think it was like Fat Kevin Drums or something like that. I don't know exactly his name, I'm just vaguely remembering. But I followed him. He was raided, and then I believe that guy raided Tito Nitro. That's why there was a crap ton of people, I think.
started noticing the others, they were watching a band. I was surprised the room was empty as before it had been rammed. And I thought, this sound is just like the one before. But you're dressed with credentials and you're running for the door. Now this ain't it seems, the way you're judging people have got now to do with music. And now I think I see just how you get your kicks. It's not about the tune, but back and forth. What if I find out your group is to divide the crowd? Let me ask you, who gave you the right to choose the wizard? You're a clown with the only criteria of what should be allowed. Can you see the fire?
funny stuff. If you're into ska, I'm sure you've heard of like Streetlight Manifesto. So if any of you guys, thanks guys, I appreciate it. If any of you guys know about like ska or heard of like Streetlight Manifesto, they are also like punk, ska, gypsy influence, like these guys. And these guys, and like, I think I've been a fan of them since like 2005 or 2004, something like that. And these guys, instrumentally, are like the closest I've seen, musically, instrumentally, that come closest to Streetlight Manifesto sound. So like, I'm on like the subreddit, and like people are recommending like Real Big Fish and like Less Than Jake and like regular ska bands. I'm like, no guys, these guys are like the closest ones, and these guys are far less rated. No way. Oh dude, you played with them? Dude, then I need to know who you were, or like what band you were part of, man. You owe that much to me. And then that also means that your bio is a little misleading, because you didn't just start drumming, man. Dude, that's amazing. Come on, man. I'm a huge fan of Catch and Streetlight and Gimp and whatnot. Dude, that's great. Okay, that makes a lot of sense. Dude, then I need to know. If you're good enough to play with those guys, like, your eon's better than my crappy local band. There's some obscure bands that I know played with, I think, Pentimento, something like that. There's like some like splits that either Catch 22, I think Catch 22 did back in the day. And I'm trying to like track them down, but it's really hard around that time because like online presence wasn't really a thing. And then MySpace went under, right? Okay, that makes sense. Yeah, playing a different instrument, that totally makes sense. We'll be right back. Thanks for the follow there, Jenny. Jenny 8. This is a good song. I think I requested Tina Nitro, or one of you guys have requested the song too before. Time. thanks so much, guys, for coming by my stream, checking it out. This will be my last song. Also, that reminds me, I'm gonna make both of you guys mods just because you guys are fellow streamers and I trust you. Apparently, you're part of the community. So I'll do that after my stream. And let me know if you have... I mean, rating doesn't really matter in this case because I have so few viewers, but it's like a good, like... It's a good gesture, so let me know if there's like any channel you think I should rate that's preferably smaller, or maybe not. Glad you guys like them. I will be sure to request some of these of you guys next time I'm in your... I check out your stream. Dude, you'd be surprised, just playing like the basic bits, not all the fills and stuff, but just the basic bits will get you pretty dang far. I actually self-taught myself to like, initially it was Less Than Jake because it's really simple, but then Streetlight Manifesto, which is crazy hard. And like, I didn't hit anything initially, but I kept at it, and like, most of my chops are influenced by their first album. But you always can reject it, man, if you think it's too hard. But I think you're actually better than you think. No problem, man. I mean, I'm not saying it just to make you feel good. I actually think that. Also, I heard good things about Rock and Sock, but they're kind of expensive. This was like back in the aughts. Not sure if Rock and Sock are still considered good. Check out that Discord again. I don't really get notifications for it, so it's easy for me to miss a lot of like good stuff on there. Maybe I should change my settings. That does sound pretty dang interesting though. Split seat. Alright. I'm gonna raid. Oh, Scott Kloppenstein. He used to be part of Billy Fish, actually. He used to play, I think, trombone or trumpet. So, I think, and he's a pretty funny guy. He used to be part of Billy Fish. And, yeah, I'm gonna rate him. Hopefully you guys enjoy him. He's pretty legit. He's one of the smaller guys. He just recently started streaming, so. Yeah, trumpet. Oh, nice. You know, all right, cool. Thanks for checking me out, guys. Really appreciate it. I'll see you guys around.